hip thrust is maybe the best exercise you can do for glutes. In this video, I'm gonna share 7 hip thrust variations without any equipment. To be honest, when it's about bodyweight hip thrust exercise, I prefer the option without a bench, sofa or couch. In this way, more muscles are engaged, especially some of the muscles that are responsible for a good posture. Are you ready? Let's go! Keep your arms straight, bring the shoulder blades together and tuck your chin. Feet are shoulder distance apart and your abs braced. Engage the glutes as much as you can as you bring the hips up and make sure your knees don't cave in. Push the chest up as much as you can and extend your spine. Hold 1-2 seconds at the top and repeat for 10 or 12 times. This time you keep your feet together and knees together. This variation is great for inner thighs and builds hip and knee stability. Squeeze your legs together as you bridge up. Don't let your knees come apart and squeeze the glutes. Brace your abs as you hip thrust and hold for 1-2 seconds. For both variations, the shins are perpendicular on the ground. Don't forget to pull the shoulders back and push the chest up as you hip thrust. This hip thrust variation takes the hamstrings pretty much out of the equation, the sole contraction being the glutes. Keep your feet together and let the knees drop out to the side. This will externally rotate the hips, so the gluteus medius is working great. These muscles are usually very inactive. Try to do full hip extension, full contraction of the glutes, and keep a neutral spine. Single leg hip thrust is a great way to correct any imbalances because the dominant leg cannot take over. Drive through the heel on the ground, brace your abs and lift your hips as high as you can without hyperextending the lower back. You need to feel your glutes working and not the lower back. Make sure you pull the shoulders back and push the chest up as you hip thrust. Here, I choose to keep the raised leg straight and parallel with the ground, which is a little bit more challenging, but you can choose to keep the leg bent or pointing to the ceiling. Now, if you want to bring the hamstrings more into equation, you need to place your feet farther away from your butt. This doesn't mean that you will let your glutes to fall asleep. Glutes and hamstrings will work together to power the bridge and hip extension. Keep your feet shoulder distance apart and don't let your knees to cave in. If you want to engage your inner thighs and still have a great focus on glutes and hamstrings, you can bring your feet together and your knees together. Squeeze your legs together as you hip thrust and don't let your knees come apart. Using the pelvic tilt for all hip thrust variations can help more your glutes and prevent hyperextension of your lower back. Crab bridge is one of my favorite exercises because it improves the mobility and of course targets the glutes. I use this unilateral variation in order to focus on each side. Drive through the heel of your bent leg and squeeze the glutes to lift your hips as high as you can. As you rise up, reach the hand from the side of your bent leg over the opposite shoulder, twisting at the torso. Engage your core so you avoid arching your back and hold the contraction at the top for 1-2 seconds. If you have an office job, this exercise is a great tool to battle the negative effect of long time sitting. If you got any value from this video, remember to subscribe and turn on the notification button so you don't miss my next videos. See you soon!